couldn't find a teardown of the Novation Circuit Tracks on the internet anywhere, so I foolishly pulled mine apart so that you don't have to experiment on yours. Here's what you're going to need. Small Phillips head screwdriver, and some kind of 10mm hex tool. I like to use ones that are made of plastic so it doesn't scratch up the hardware. And then, optional, but I think it's pretty useful, some kind of magnetic dish or tray to hold on to the hex nuts and the screws so that you don't lose them. This one's already like half pulled apart. I just sort of slapped it back together for the video, so this is going to be a lot easier for me right now than it will be for you. First thing you need to do is to pull the knobs. I actually pulled this first one with so much force, it went flying across the room, so do be careful. You might want to back it a little bit. They come right off. They really only have those two little splines in them to hold them to the D-shaft knobs. And as far as putting them back later, the master volume and the master filter have these white lines in the center because they're the actual potentiometers. And the rest of them, since they're rotary encoders, endless, they're all just solid black. So pull those. And underneath them are hex nuts. Now I've pulled most of these, but I put one back on the volume just to show you that's where you're going to use the hex tool. And those come right out. All of that's pretty straightforward. This is where it starts to venture into the realm of the devious. This thing may fall apart as I'm turning it over. Okay. So the bottom rubber strip on the back. I assumed that there would be screws on the four corners. That pulls up. It's got some adhesive on the back. You know, you can always put some more adhesive on that to glue it back down. These little silver screws, they are ornery little boogers. They don't want to come loose, even once you've completely detached them. I left this one loose intentionally, and yet you have to kind of like get in there and pull it. That's where the flathead comes in handy. So those two are pretty straightforward. And here's where we start to get into Novation's deviousness. When you pull the top rubber strip, it looks like there aren't any screws. It looks like there's some kind of case fitting here, but it's not. These are just two stoppers that they've put in there, like little plastic cylinders, so be careful. I'm bracing them with my thumbs, fingers. They're gonna fall right out. So I put those somewhere safe. And underneath them, that's where the screws live. And they're painted black to try to make them blend in with the plastic of the case. A little devious. Not ultra devious, but a little. Novation really doesn't want you to pull these things apart. Come on, little magnetic screwdriver, you can do it. There you go. So, put those in a safe place. And that's where I hit a roadblock. Because then, you know, I went looking for the seams, and they're not along the sides, they're on the top. And I spent a lot of time with a small flathead screwdriver, like the smallest I could get, just gently prying these edges loose. Once you've got the screws out of the back of them, it's not too bad. The problem is, once you've got the top loose, it still doesn't want to come apart. So I thought maybe there was a post or something with another screw, or maybe there was a really, really tight ribbon cable inside that was holding the two circuit boards together for the interface on top. And what I'm assuming is the battery and the MIDI jacks and everything on the bottom. And then I decided to take another look at the back. And that's when I realized, and you might be able to tell by the scuffing and the finger marks, the friggin' Novation logo. It comes with a little plastic protective cover. I peeled that off. And if you take a screwdriver, smallest you can get, and pry at the edges, yep, there's another screw under there. Put this off to the side. Now, this is as far as I've gone, so Welcome to unknown territory with me. I haven't removed this screw yet, but I am assuming it's the fly in the ointment. Luckily that one came right out. Hopefully that's the only one. There could be more under that adhesive, maybe. Oh, ho ho ho, look at that. And that's where we run into some, yeah, it looks like some very, very flimsy, oh wow, very flimsy ribbon cables. I mean, ultra thin. So I'm supporting the weight of it. The main reason I wanted to take mine apart was I assumed that the rechargeable lithium battery is going to come apart at some point, stop working, stop charging. So I wanted to get this information. Hopefully the camera's picking that up pretty well. This is the battery, it looks like. LP306987-1S-3. LP306987-1S-3. Rechargeable lithium battery, 3.7 volt, 2200 milliampere hour, 8.14 watt hours. Designation 1, CP37087, manufacturer Shenzhen, Back Technology Company Limited. It is minuscule. It is really tiny. It's ultra thin. Because, you know, this is the entire case backing. And this thing is flat, like credit card flat. And little SMD components, surface mount there, and then the three wires. We've got a black, a yellow, and a red. And that's as far as I'm going to go today, folks. I'm going to put this back together and hope that it still functions. Should. But it looks like we've got our snap together connector for the battery. And then we've got two ribbon cables, one that connects the MIDI assembly, the power jack, audio in and out, from its own circuit board to these two boards that are connected to the user interface on the top. We've got some foam strips. Looks like four of those. And then just, oh my gosh, these ribbon cables. They don't look like you could pull them. I mean, you could, but they are just super paper thin. I'm already worried I put too much strain on them as it is. Mostly surface mount components, which you'd expect. Looks like some electrolytic capacitors that maybe you could replace if you needed to. But yeah, that is how you take apart the Novation Circuit Tracks, and that is the battery you're going to need if it ever goes bad, or, you know, equivalent. 3.7 volts at 2200 milliampere hours, 3-wire. Good luck out there. One more thing. I was about to put everything back together when I thought, let's poke around a little bit more inside and see what we can see. And I'm really glad that I did, because there's one thing that should have jumped out of me immediately, which is, even though I purchased this Circuit Tracks many, many months before the Circuit Rhythm was ever released by Novation, if you take more than just the glancing look that I did at the circuit board, you'll realize that two of the boards, both the main board and the potentiometer board, are labeled Circuit Rhythm / Tracks. Rhythm / Tracks, version 3.1, pot board, FSR board. Now, I know sometimes devices from the same manufacturer will have the same circuit board, but different layout of components and obviously different software implementations. I don't know exactly how similar the Tracks and the Rhythm really are, but this opens the door to possible cross-pollination. So do with that as you will. And finally, proof of life video, all back together, buttoned up. Cheap little amplifier on. Power on circuit. Not full battery, but good enough. It lives.